YouTube, Genesis 52 here with Palm Beach Max Airport update number one. Now, I'm sure you're probably wondering what the Max is, but basically I've bought, so my Palm Beach mat has always been on this kind of poster board tip material here to the right. And what I did was I bought another one, and while I'm still trying to figure out what to do with the other side of it, on the one half, or like one, since double side, one side, I decided to extend the Palm Beach mat. So basically this whole lighter white part over here is the new Palm Beach extension. Oh, I can get this over to stay. Sorry, I'm just trying to get this guy over here to stay up. The silver saw 340 is very tiny. There we go, sorry. So here's the original one, and the other one here has been extended, and this is an imaginary one. But basically I'm going to explain you what I extended and what I did with the airport. So the original side, not going to explain where all the airlines were, but basically I moved the airlines all around. They all have new parking spots on this mat. Every airline's been expanded in size. The C concourse, which is here where the JetBlues are, is now the D concourse, has been extended to the D concourse over here. And the B concourse here, A concourse, has been extended out here with the A concourse hard stance. Reason I did a hard stance was because I wanted to keep, so this one is oriented this way and this one's oriented this way, so it's too narrow to do two taxiways and runways over here. So I wanted to keep it so there's no gates through here, and then the hard stands take up less space, and I can put a runway on the end and a small de-ice slash run-up area over there. Not really much de-ice, it's really just a whole short pad. Obviously it's Florida, so there's no de-icing. If there is, you got bigger problems. But basically it's just a pad over there. And this airport mat will be used for other things, probably some intermountainous airports. But then comment down below what you think I should do with the other side. I'm gonna get right into the update. So Delta's the largest airline here. American, JetBlue are very big, have not expanded Southwest too much, just one extra gate. Brought Alaskan, Virgin, America in, brought Allegiant back, brought Spirit and more, Frontier more, United and a little more. Everything's a little bit more expanded, and it's a real cool airport. I think I'm not finished making it completely. I gotta do the runway over there and continue the taxiways, but as of right now, this will be Palm Beach Max number one. Six new models in here, two of them are customs, and I will show you exactly what they are as we go through and kind of explain the deal with them. But first up's an older model, Delta Connection, UN70, operated by Republic Airlines, lining up for a flight to Houston Intercontinental. All the way at the other end of that runway, we have a United. Yeah, I also just bought this lamp over here, so it's gonna make things a lot brighter during the updates. Hopefully you guys like that. United 737-900ER. Eco Skies, the colors are just looking awesome right here. Just pulling in, taxiing for a flight from Newark. And then another new model. This one will become a One World aircraft, most likely. With the American Airlines 737-800s on its way from Phoenix Sky Harbor. Over to our B concourse right here. And we're gonna start off with the gate this United's heading into. Is empty, and then we have a United 737-800 getting some bags and servicing for flight to Denver. Delta 737-900ER, there's gonna be tons of these 900s in here. This 900 is gonna be headed to JFK, then a Delta A321 catering for Atlanta. Empty Delta Airlines regional gate, then we have another Republic UN70 for Delta headed to Orlando. Delta 757-200 to Salt Lake City, Alaska 737-900ER to Seattle, Tacoma, sorry. Pushing back is a Delta MD-88 to Baltimore. Then Delta 717 to Raleigh-Durham. Off to our A concourse now, Delta 737-900ER to Minneapolis-St. Paul. Empty Delta gate, we have an A320 pulling in from Boston. Then an MD-90 for Delta to New York LaGuardia. SkyTeam 757-200 is going to be making a flight over to Los Angeles. And then our 767-300ER is headed to Atlanta. After that is an Allegiant A319. We'll be making a flight to Cincinnati. An Air Canada Rouge A319 to Cincinnati. Then our other side of the A-comers, we have a Spirit A321 headed to Los Angeles, Spirit A320, Sharklets to Detroit, And then Sun Country, 737-800 to Minneapolis. Frontier 319 pulling in from Cincinnati. And then a Frontier 320 just getting ready to make a flight out to Denver. And this is Betty the Bluebird, the newest custom that I've made. Again, check out Rocky Mountain Customs. I can kind of make you whatever you want. So yeah, here's the other side of Betty the Bluebird. Still waiting on some new nose gear for it, as you can see in the Super Tug, but that's why I put it in the Super Tug, because you can't see it. All right, move over to our taxiway. A JetBlue A320, holding short of the imaginary runway over there for a flight to New York LaGuardia. Southwest 737-700 Triple Crown ones taking off to a Dallas Love. Silver Airways South 340B Plus to Orlando. And we're over to our D Concourse. I just totally hit the belt 7-6. I put one wide body gate on the hard scenes over here. And the American gates where the two planes in the middle there are, that's also a wide body gate for when the heavies come in, because there will be some international flights in the peak season, so be ready for that. Southwest 737-800, new model, headed to Denver. I actually just got this. It's really cool. my second one, but I really am glad I have it now. Empty Southwest gate, Southwest 737-300, headed to Atlanta. Southwest 737-700 to Chicago Midway. JetBlue A320 to Newark. JetBlue E190 to Hartford, Windsor Locks. JetBlue 321 to JFK. JetBlue 320 Vets in Blue to Boston. Empty JetBlue gate, and then a JetBlue E190 to Orlando, and a Virgin America A320 to San Francisco. Whew, that was a lot. Empty Silver Airways is now going to be parking at C7 or C6. It's this little gate in here. I got to redo some of the foils and mats over here, because as you can see, I just put note cards over the poster board whenever I'd screw up. I have since modernized from that to doing just stickers, but I've also gotten better at doing it. But I'm going to fix all that up later on. All these lines need to be redrawn on this side as well. So this is a pretty big project for me. So you will be seeing a lot more of these types of mats. So I'm going to think of them. But this is the Silvergate. Over to American Airlines side. First up is American Airlines PSA operated CRJ-700 to Atlanta, Georgia. For another new model, this is a custom I did. It's the American A319 Piedmont Heritage livery. Headed to Philadelphia. I will be doing more of the Heritage livery. Really easy transition. I can get those for you guys if you want me to do one for you for just $10 plus whatever the donor model costs. So it's a real cheap custom. Looks really cool. Beautiful looking thing. Another new model is an American A321. Again, my second one. This guy's headed to Los Angeles. American 757-200 to Dallas-Fort Worth. Empty American Airlines gate, and then the new model. Actually got this one for free from DSM Aviation. He doesn't have any more, so he's not going to give it for free. I got a big bunch of models from him, as well as a couple of the new ones in here. And this one didn't have a nose gear, but I found a nose gear from another plane that I was using as parts. Slapped it on here, so. This guy's a new model, headed to Washington Reagan. And last but not least, we have our American Airlines TWA retro plane, headed to Charlotte Douglas. I just wanted to snap a cool little picture of it over here.